नमस्ते, माय सेल्फ सज्जनंद, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर, डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ मैकेनिकल इंजीनियरिंग। एज इन द कंटिन्यूएशन ऑफ नॉन डिस्ट्रक्टिव टेस्टिंग वी रीच टू द अनदर टेस्टिंग मेथड दैट इज कॉल्ड अल्ट्रासोनिक टेस्टिंग मेथड। दिस अल्ट्रासोनिक टेस्ट यूटिलाइजिंग द साउंड वेव्स which passes through the material, or you can say inside the material, when it goes inside the material, the waves which are traveling inside the material can be represented on the CRT screen. And the distance which is traveled by that sound waves is to be monitored on that CRO screens. If it is in specific length, means that portion is good. If it is shorter in length, means there is something which is present inside the material. So for this, we are going to discuss about the ultrasonic testing, how it works, where it works, what are the equipments, what are the accessories, what are the advantages and disadvantages which are implicated with this ultrasonic testing. So let's begin. So starting with this ultrasonic test part, that is ultrasonic testing, that some of the introduction, which is you can identify from this figure as well, इसमें आप देख सकते हैं कि एक आदमी, एक इंजीनियर कैसे इस रेलवे ट्रैक को, मटेरियल को टेस्ट कर रहा है, और इसके लिए ज़्यादा कोई स्पेशल इक्विपमेंट की जरूरत नहीं है। एक ट्रांसड्यूसर है, एक CRT स्क्रीन है, और ये इजीली कैरिबल है, कहीं भी इसको ले जा सकते हैं। और यही खूबी और एक खासियत है इस NDT मेथड्स की कि ये कंपेटेबल है, इनके जो टेस्टिंग इक्विपमेंट्स हैं उनको किसी भी लोकेशंस पे हम इजीली कैरी कर सकते हैं, और जो मटेरियल इन सर्विस में है, जैसे कि आए रेलवे ट्रैक का जो मटेरियल है वो सर्विस में है, उस मटेरियल के मेंटेनेंस के रिगार्डिंग हम बार बार उसको चेक कर सकते हैं। सो दैट इज वाई दिस NDT मेथड्स are different from the DT method. So let's begin with the introduction and the some kind of a definition parts. What is ultrasonic testing and what is ultrasonic is all about. So this ultrasonic non-destructive testing is also known as ultrasonic NDT. Or simply UT. So these three names which are indicated to identify this test. So this UT is the method of characterizing the thickness or internal structure of a test piece through the use of high frequency साउंड वेव्स. सो दीज साउंड वेव्स हैव द टेंडेंसी टू ट्रेवल इनसाइड द मटेरियल when they travel inside the material they reflected from the surface and that reflection or any discontinuity inside the material is captured on the CRT screen. The frequencies or pitch used for ultrasonic testing are mainly times higher than the limit of human hearing. This is specification of this sound wave. That sound waves are above the limitation to hearing, the human hearing power, that is about 500 kilohertz to 20 millihertz, megahertz, sorry. So, with the help of sound waves, we can check the internal structure of the screen. Either it is in service or it is just after the production. So in the figure, this is the figure, you can see here, this is the workpiece and these are the sound waves which are traveling inside the material. You can see here, these arrows are also showing these particular sound waves. When this transducer sending that sound waves, they travel through it and reaches to the bottom level and then reflect to that position. And that reflection is identified at the CRT screen. As you can see, there is a difference in this two figure, that one sound wave is providing a full length arrow, but the second figure is providing a small short length of arrow. It means that arrow is stuck with some kind of a flaws, some kind of a crack inside the material. Some may be here. So when this short wavelength is showing on the CRT screen, we can identify that there is something, some kind of a flaw, some kind of a impurity, some kind of a defects are present at that particular location inside the material. And that is how this ultrasonic test is helped, is providing the help to detect the internal structure of the material, either in the service or without in the service, you can say after the production. So what sort of material that can be tested? So in industrial application, ultrasonic testing is widely used, obviously, on the metals. They are widely used, utilizing on the metals, the plastics, composites and the ceramic materials, which allows to travel the sound wave from them. So the commonly engineered materials that are not suitable for ultrasonic testing with conventional equipment are wood, paper products. So these are the materials which are not to be tested by the ultrasonic test. Means they does not allow the sound waves to travel inside them. Only metals, plastic, composites and ceramic material will allow them to travel inside them and to detect there is any flaws or any kind of a problem is presented inside the material. So along with this, the ultrasonic testing is also widely used in the biomedical field for diagnostic, imaging and medical research. So, with respect to the engineering, the medical field also utilizing these sound waves to diagnose the internal structure of the body, that we are utilizing a term that is the ultrasound. कि किसी के पेट में अगर दर्द हो रहा है या फिर पेट से रिलेटेड कोई चीज है तो उसको अल्ट्रासाउंड करा लो. दैट अल्ट्रासाउंड्स आर यूटिलाइजिंग दिस काइंड ऑफ अ साउंड वेव्स व्हिच इज ट्रेवलिंग थ्रू द मटेरियल इनसाइड द मटेरियल एंड प्रोवाइडिंग द काइंड ऑफ अ इमेजिंग दैट हैव द डिफरेंट काइंड ऑफ फ्रीक्वेंसी रेंज बट द वर्किंग इज सेम to sending the sound wave and take the imaging. So how does it work? So high frequency sound waves are very directional and they will travel through a medium. The sound waves are very directional, means if they find any kind of a destruction, they will deviate their position. So for that, we will pass them through a medium that is called the couplant. What is this mean, couplant? We will discuss in the next slides. Like a piece of a steel or the plastic, until they encounter a boundary with another medium like an air. Agar direct aap is particular figure mein dekh sakte hain, isko hum ek tarah se chipka ke hi material ke upar select kar rahe hain. Agar isko jara sa bhi upar ki taraf lift kar denge, to yahan se air pass hona shuru ho jayega. और जब एयर पास होना शुरू हो गया तो ये साउंड वेव को डिफ्लेक्ट कर सकता है. और इसीलिए आप देखते हैं जब ये पर्टिकुलर हम ट्रांसड्यूसर को यूज कर रहे हैं, इस ट्रांसड्यूसर में ये ग्रीन कलर का मटेरियल दिखाई दे रहा होगा, दैट इज कॉल्ड द कपलेट. ये क्या करता है, एक सीलिंग प्रोवाइड करता है बाहरी इन्वायरमेंट के रिस्पेक्ट में. उसके बारे में हम लोग डिस्कस करेंगे क्या चीजें हैं. यहाँ पे वही चीजें बताई जा रही है कि हाई फ्रिक्वेंसी साउंड वेव आर वेरी डायरेक्शनल, एक ही डायरेक्शन में मूव करने की आदत होती है. एंड दे ट्रेवल थ्रू अ मीडियम अंटिल दे एनकाउंटर अ बाउंड्री विद अनदर मीडियम एट विच पॉइंट दे रिफ्लेक्ट बैक टू देयर सोर्स. सो अगर कोई बाहर की फ्रीक्वेंसी या बाहर की कोई अनदर चीज आके उसे स्ट्राइक करेगी तो इट हैव सम चांसेस टू रिफ्लेक्ट बैक. सो बाय एनालाइजिंग दिस रिफ्लेक्शन इट इज पॉसिबल टू मेजर द थिकनेस ऑफ द टेस्ट पीस. That how thick that particular material is, means that particular sound wave will travel through the material and that will identify the depth of that particular material, the thickness of that particular material. Or it will find out the evidence of the crack or other hidden internal flaws which are left during the processing of the material, like the casting, there is some kind of impurities available which didn't melt at that time. When you are doing some kind of a welding, some tungsten particle left inside the weld pool and so on. So identifying these kind of a specimens, we need to use this kind of ultrasonic test to check the internal crack or the flaws. So in ultrasonic testing, an ultrasound transducer connected to a diagnostic machine which is passed over the object being inspected. So this is the transducer. That transducer is that is connected to that particular material, that particular diagnostic machine. So what are the purpose of this particular transducer? It provides the medium to travel the sound wave from the machine to the material. So transducer is typically separated from the test object by a couplet, this transducer, and this is the couplet which is separate them. So the transducer is typically separated from the test object by a couplet such as oil or water as in immersion testing. So these are the basic kind of a couplet which are utilizing for the testing. A couplet is a material usually liquid. So what is the couplet? Now we are going to discuss. So I hope you are understanding what we are doing to discuss, what we want to understand, that there is a simple transducer which is connected to the machine, and that transducer is providing a kind of a sound waves, and that sound wave travels through the material, and that traveling of material of sound wave can be identified in this particular receivers. So there are the different methods to identify that we will discuss later, but we will move step by step. First we talked about the transducer, what is the role of transducer, and now we are going to talk about the couplet, what are the couplet materials and what are the roles. So the couplet is a material, usually liquid, that facilitates the transmission of ultrasonic energy from the transducer into the test specimen. So the test specimen is working . So this couplet material, usually liquid based material, that facilitate the transmission of electronic ultrasonic energy from the transducer into the test specimen. So एक तरह का medium है जो sound waves को transducer से workpiece के अंदर travel कराता है without any disturbance, that we discussed earlier, that the sound wave moving in a very directional way. So without disturbance from any outside activity, this couplet provide a specific medium to transfer this particular ultrasonic range sound waves to travel through the material. So the couplet is generally necessary because the acoustic impedance mismatch between the air and the solid, which we discussed the point that this particular point having some kind of a regulations, or if we do not take that particular precautions, that will hamper the result of that particular test. So such as this test specimen is larger in that, and which is encountering continuous air between the couplet and the workpiece or transducer or the workpiece, that will deviate the sound waves, and that this will lead to the mismatch of the test result. So the couplet displaces the air and make it possible to get more sound energy into the test specimen. So as you can say in the other word, they are providing a vacuum between the transducer and the workpiece, and do not allow any unwanted particles or the materials in between them. So the couplet which displaces the air, providing a more space to travel the sound wave into the material or the test specimen, so that the usable ultrasonic signal can be obtained. So what will happen when the ultrasonic signal will obtain? That will provide a maximum possibility to identification of the flaws and the structure which is present inside the material. So in contact ultrasonic testing, a thin film of oil, glycerin or water is generally used between the transducer and the test surface. So these type of material, glycerin ho gaya, aapka water ho gaya, a kind of a thin film oil ho gaya, उसको हम लोग पर्टिकुलर कपलेंट के ऊपर लगाते हैं और उसको मटेरियल के ऊपर प्लेस करते हैं, जो कि बाहर से आने वाले एयर को उसमें इंटर नहीं होने देता है। और जब वो बाहर से आने वाला एयर इंटर नहीं होगा तो जो साउंड वेव का डायरेक्शनल मूवमेंट है वो बना रहेगा और उससे हमें सही तरीके से टेस्ट रिजल्ट प्राप्त हो जाएंगे। नाउ वी आर गोइंग टू टॉक अबाउट वॉट इज कपलेंट। आई होप यू अंडरस्टैंड हाउ दिस पर्टिकुलर अल्ट्रासोनिक मशीन विल वर्क। इट इज सिंपल, दैट इज द रिसीवर, दैट पर्टिकुलर इज रिसीवर विच इज शोइंग द सीआर विच इज हैपनिंग विद द दिस इज द बेसिकली सीआरटी स्क्रीन, दैट इज द सीआरटी स्क्रीन विच इज शोइंग द साउंड वेव विच इज ट्रेवलिंग थ्रू द मटेरियल विच इज ट्रेवलिंग थ्रू द ट्रांसड्यूसर into the material, and that when they return from the material, this transducer have the capability to transduce or to receive the sound wave, and the receiving sound waves are reflecting in this CRT screen, and it is that simple. It is simple tarika hai, ek transducer hai jisko hum workpiece ke upar rakh rahe hain, wohi transmission aur receiver ka bhi kaam karta hai। एक बार वो साउंड वेव्स को मटेरियल के अंदर छोड़ेगा और जब वो मटेरियल के अंदर साउंड वेव जाके टकरा के वापस आएगा, उसी साउंड वेव को रिसीव करके वो सीआरटी स्क्रीन पे शो करेगा। और जैसा जैसा डिफ्लेक्शन शो होगा सीआरटी पे, हमें पता चल जाएगा कि इस पर्टिकुलर लोकेशंस पे कौन कौन से डिफेक्ट्स हैं, एंड दैट इज हाउ दिस पर्टिकुलर अल्ट्रासोनिक टेस्ट इज टू बी वर्क। बट दिस द सिंपल वे विच आई एम एक्सप्लेनिंग, इट इज some of the very finer and you can say an expert is required to check this kind of, to perform this kind of a test. So why this kind of test to be performed with the expert is because there is some kind of limitations. If we didn't provide some kind of limitation and didn't follow the kind of a standard which is set by the AWS, American Welding Society, to examine this kind of test result for a specific area, that is the fabrication field, the test result will hamper, and when the test result will hamper, the structure will lead to the failure. So that is why this ultrasonic test is required a skilled person who is perform a various kind of a level of clear the level of test, as well as the standard is also performed by the some ASTM methods and that the thing. So now the couplant, which are very useful material to transport the sound waves from the transducer into the material. If this material will not be available in between them, the result, test result of ultrasonic test will get hampered. So what is couplant? Let's see. A couplant is a material, usually liquid, that facilitates the transmission of ultrasonic energy from the transducer into the test specimen. So the thing which we discussed. So couplant is generally necessary because the acoustic impedance mismatch between air and the solid, such as the test specimen, is larger. So therefore, nearly all of energy is reflected and very little is transmitted into the material. Why? Because of the introduction of between the air and the solid. So for maintaining this gap, we are requiring these particular couplant materials. Therefore, the couplant displaces the air and make it possible to get more sound energy into the test specimen, so that a usable ultrasonic signal can be obtained. In contrast, the ultrasonic testing, a thin film of oil grease in water is generally used between the transducer and the test specimen. As you can see, this is the black portion is showing the couplant, this is the contact transducer, and this is the test specimen. So these all three are the major particular, these three are the major combinations which is need to be taken care when we performing the ultrasonic test. And there is another method, there are the two type of method which we are utilizing, that is the direct apply method and that is the submerged method, that is the water couplant, as you can see here. So what is happening when scanning over the part or making precise measurement, and immersion technique is often used. This particular immersion that is not allowed to travel any kind of a substance. In immersion ultrasonic test, both the transducer and the part are immersed in the couplet. Both these things. What are this is? This is in the open air. This is in the particular immersion in the couplet material. So both the transducer and the particular material are in a single medium. There is no allowing of extra material or extra source like air in between the transducer and the material which is to be tested. So the transducer and the part which are immersed in the couplet, which is typically a water, basically water. So this method of coupling make it easier to maintain consistent coupling while moving and manipulating the transducer or the part. So these two methods which are utilizing, one is the submergence of this particular transducer and the workpiece. Another is the direct method applying of couplet. So these two method of couplet utilizing to identify these ultrasonic test results inside the material. Now, there are two methods of receiving the ultrasonic sound waveform. As I told you, the transducer providing, this transducer is providing with that particular, the transmission and emission process. That is the transmission and this is the receiving. So there are the two methods of to receiving the ultrasound waveform, the reflection and actuation. So what is reflection or the pulse echo mode? So this is the pulse echo mode which is utilized in the first method to identify, which is shown into the first figure of that introductory part of that particular slides. That a person which is taking a simple transducer, the pulse echo mode transducer in his hand and checking the railway track. So the transducer performs both the sending and the receiving of the pulse wave as the sound is reflected back to the device, which is showing here. The reflected ultrasound comes from an interference such as backup wall of the object from an imperfection within the object. So do tarike se sound wave reflect karenge. Ek to jab wo material ke last portion tak pahunchega wahan se reflect karega agar uske andar koi defect nahi hai. या अगर कोई क्रैक आ जाएगा उस पर्टिकुलर मटेरियल के अंदर, क्रैक है और वहां से साउंड वेव जा रहा है तो वो वहीं से रिफ्लेक्ट कर जाएगा. सो दो पॉसिबिलिटीज हैं और दोनों पॉसिबिलिटी में वो साउंड वेव टकरा के वापस आएगा और यही टकरा के वापस आना इस ट्रांसड्यूसर का काम है, ट्रांसमिट करके रिसीव करना, जो कि पल्स इको मेथड से काम करता है. और जब ये रिसीव करता है तो उसका इम्प्रेशन जो है इस पर्टिकुलर सीआरटी स्क्रीन पे देख सकते हैं आप. ये हाई पीक बता रहा है कि ये पूरा मेटल जो है विदाउट डिफेक्ट है इस पोर्शन पे, बट इस पर्टिकुलर लोकेशन पे मटेरियल की कहीं ना कहीं कोई डिफेक्ट अवेलेबल है. सो इट इज दैट सिंपल मटेरियल टेस्टिंग मेथड्स, बट इट इज वेरी प्रिसाइजली एंड स्किल्ड लेबर रिक्वायर्ड टू आइडेंटिफाई दिस काइंड ऑफ सिग्नल्स टू आइडेंटिफाई. So the diagnostic machine displays this result in the form of signal with an amplitude representing the intensity of the reflection, that particular thing, and representing the arrival time of a reflection and how much time that particular sound wave is taking place to reflect. And this another second figure is showing the infrared sensing, or you can say the thermal sensing of the sound waves which are representing on the thermal screen. As you can see, these sound waves are traveling inside the material and there is some kind of a defect present here which is representing on this thermal screen. So this is the advanced technique which is utilizing to identify the crack or flaw inside the material with the help of these ultrasounds, means the sound waves. The second one is the actuation, that is the through transmission mode, means one transducer is transmitting the sound wave, another one is using to receive that sound waves. So this is the two kind of method which are utilizing to identify this ultrasonic or to perform the ultrasonic test as per the requirement. So a transmitter send ultrasound through one surface and a separate receiver detects the amount that has reached it on another surface after traveling through the medium. So the imperfection or other condition in the space between the transmitter and the receiver reduce the amount of sound transmitted, thus revealing their presence. So what is the basic of benefits and the procedure we will discussing here? Why we are using this? So the transmitter send the ultrasound through one surface, as you can see in this particular figure, that particular transmitter transducer is sending the sound wave inside the material, and a separate receiver detects the amount that has reached in the another surface after traveling through the medium. तो यहाँ पे जब मटेरियल ट्रेवल साउंड वेव ट्रेवल कर रहा है, जब वो ट्रेवल कर दिया तो दूसरा वाला रिसीवर क्या रिसीव करेगा कि वो कितने दूर तक ट्रेवल किया, और वही रिसीविंग उतना ट्रेवलिंग साउंड वेव को वो डिटेक्ट करेगा और उसको रिप्रेजेंट करेगा इस पर्टिकुलर स्क्रीन में. सो द इम्परफेक्शन और अदर कंडीशन इन स्पेस बिटवीन द ट्रांसमीटर एंड रिसीवर रिड्यूस द अमाउंट ऑफ साउंड ट्रांसमिटेड, थस रिवीलिंग देयर प्रेजेंस. So what this point is indicating, that the using of couplet increase the efficiency of the process by reducing the losses in the ultrasonic wave energy due to the separation between the surface. So as we discussed earlier about the couplet, but what is the benefit of this transmitter and receiver? That imperfection or the other condition in the space means this particular location inside the material. The transmitter and the receiver reduce the amount of sound transmitted, means the traveling locations with that particular transmitter and the receiver reduces the amount of sound transmission, and that they detect very fast and very easily, and detect very easily the defect or any flaws, and that is how this particular actuation or through the transmission process is utilizing. So both the method are well. Both matter are in working condition is perfectly. There some have their another kind of importance, some have their other kind of importance. So according to the requirement, we develop this kind of material, this kind of test method. So the transmitter technique is a way which receives the pulse generated from transmitting probe by receiving probe. So we can know the size and shape of the defect by detecting the strength of the transmitted wave, because the detect decrease ultrasonic pulse power through inside of the material. So this is the basic thing which is showing in these figures, and in this figure you can identify this particular, that particular two probes having the providing the space to travel that particular sound and transmit the particular sound in a very reduced manner. So so this transmitter and receiver are providing this particular signal, and that is how this particular test result is to be identified here. So this is the reflection technique, echo method, and this is the transmission technique, that is a pulse transmission technique. So this figure, both the figure identifying by this particular two methods, that is the reflection method technique and the transmission technique, both are utilizing. As you can see the sound wave, how this particular sound waves are receiving transmitting through it, and how this particular transmitting the ecosystem, the pulse ecosystem which is showing. Okay. So ultrasonic inspection is very useful and versatile entity method. Some of the advantage in ultrasonic inspection are often cited. So it is sensitive to both surface and subsurface discontinuity. So let me explain this particular figure that is showing the pulse ecosystem, and second one is the transmission system. डोंट बी गेट कंफ्यूज बाय दिस पर्टिकुलर दैट देयर इज ओनली वन पल्स इकोसिस्टम इज यूटिलाइजिंग द पर्टिकुलर सिग्नल दैट देयर इज अ मेथड इज ऑल्सो रिसीविंग दैट द हैविंग द काइंड ऑफ अ ट्रांसमीटर एंड द रिसीवर इज ऑल्सो यूटिलाइजिंग इन द इको सिस्टम पल्स इको मेथड एज वेल एज इन द ट्रांसमिशन ऑल्सो. So these things is to be identified and don't get confused that the pulse echo method is the only single transducer, that transducer and the receiver, right? So that is the point which we are receiving, that the figure is showing by these two kind of transducer, but this transducer is nothing but this is just showing the reflection of this particular. So these are in the coexistence. This is not the second kind of a transducer which is utilizing this transmission method. That one is the transducer, transmitter, and second one is the receiver. So in the earlier lecture, I told you, I explained this particular by transducer by this figure, but basically this is related to this, and this particular receiver is showing from here. Okay. So now next is the advantage. It is sensitive to both surface and subsurface discontinuities. The depth of penetration for flaws, detection or measurement is superior to other NDT methods. And only single-sided access is needed when the pulse echo technique is used. That the thing which we are utilizing in this particular pulse echo. It is highly accurate in determining reflector position and estimating size and shape. The minimum part preparation is required. That is the advantage of this. The electronic equipment provide instantaneous results. Detailed image can produce with automated system, and it has other uses such as thickness measurement and additional frost detection. So these ultrasonic tests can be identified by the two methods, the pulse echo method and the transmission method. In pulse echo method, the transducer is also a transmitter and the receiver, and in the transmission method, one is the transducer is the transmitting the energy, another is receiving the energy. So this is the basic difference between the echo pulse system and the transmission pulse system. Now the advantages we discussed, now we discuss the limitations of this method. The surface must be accessible to transmit ultrasound. The skill and training is more extensive than the some other methods. As I told you, the skilled laborer, a skilled person is required for this testing, as it is a highly precise inspection which are utilizing. It is normally require a coupling medium to promote the transfer of the sound energy. Why we discussed? Because if there is a gap, the air will strike in between the transducer and the medium of the specimen, and that will deflect the particular sound wave. So for avoiding this kind of a deflection, we are required the coupling medium, that is the in the form of water or in the form of oil or a glycerin. So the material that are rough, irregular in shape, very small, expansionally thin or non homogeneous are difficult to inspect. So regular shape material will easily check. Small size material is difficult to check. Exceptionally thin and which are not homogeneous in the structure, that atomic structure, which is just difficult to inspect, that we discussed, that which kind of material is not identified, that is the paper and the wood. So the cast iron and the coarse is also the grain materials are difficult to inspect due to the low sound transmission and high signal noise, as their structures are in the very brittle, they are in the martensite structures. So the linear defect oriented parallel to the sound beam may go undetected. Some of the problem with that particular, that some of the defect which are in the linear position of the sound waves, that You can say in the parallel position that sound will be traveling from here and it is in the linear motion of that particular position. So maybe it is possible that particular sound will transmit through the particular crack also. So for that reason, we are utilizing the two types of method, the transverse and the longitudinal ultrasonic testing, that the sound wave which are traveling through the in the zigzag motion or in the perpendicular motion as well, to identify and to overcome this kind of a problem. So the sound wave which are traveling in the transverse mode or the longitudinal mode, which is depending that to how precisely we are taking care of these particular defects. So this point is need to be taken care, and that the point which I told you that sound wave which are traveling is not in the single position, that is in the some transverse motion also, to detect, to overcome this kind of a problem. So the reference standard are required for both equipment calibration and the characterization of flaws. So these particular tests are to be performed under the standardization of AWS, American Welding Society. They provide us some kind of standard to how this particular test is to be taken care regarding with respect to the material and the for the better test result. So this point is need to be taken care. So this is the some kind of a in-service test result of the specimen of the, which is completed by the ultrasonic test. So the ultrasonic test, which basically we are utilizing on the weld, so one of the most useful characteristic of the ultrasonic testing is the ability to determine the exact position of discontinuity in the weld. So this is the particular perfect for this particular location finding of the crack inside the weld, and that is why it is utilizing and is standardized by the AWS. And this testing method required a high level of operator, as I told you, the training and the competence, and is dependent on the stabilization and application of suitable testing procedures. So this testing method can be used on ferrous and non-ferrous materials as well, is often suited for testing thicker sections which are accessible from the one side only, and can often detect finer line or clearer defect which may not be readily detected by radiography testing standards. So to overcome another testing methods, we are utilizing these sound waves as they are traveling in the longitudinal and the transverse motion to identify the every aspects of the crack which are present in the particular material. So these are the international standard organizations which are providing the test result phenomena as International Organization for Standardization, that is ISO, European Committee for Standardization. They are providing the various kind of test methods at the standards as well with respect to the AWS also. And that is how we check the materials with respect to this particular test standard and AWS also test standard which we are following for examining this ultrasonic test. So this is all about the ultrasonic testing. And don't get confused about the pulse echo and the transmission machine. And again, I want to tell you, in the pulse echo, a single transducer is utilizing for transmitting and receiving the sound waves. And in the transmission method, two transducer are utilizing. One is utilizing for transmitting the sound wave, and another one is utilizing to receiving the sound wave as per that particular complication. These two hand is to be fixed to identify this particular thing, and that's why the pulse ecosystem is more convenient to examine the ultrasonic test. And that is on that scenario I am holding this lecture. If any query or any message, you can ask. Okay, so thank you.